Hey everyone, this is Lynn Bartam, and you are listening to the Apex Hour on KSUU Thunder 91.1. In this show, you get more personal time with the guests who visit Southern Utah University from all over, learning more about their stories and opinions beyond their presentations on stage. We will also give you some new music to listen to and hope to turn you on to some new sounds and new genres. You can find us here every Thursday at 3 p.m. or on the web at seu.edu/apex. But for now, welcome to this week's show here on Thunder 91.1.
Well, welcome everybody. It's the Apex Hour. This is Lynn Bartan, and you are listening to KSUU Thunder 91.1. So what are we up to today? Today is here in the studio, one of the last weeks of June. It's actually the longest day of June. We're getting to the end, June 21st, 2018. And today I'm going to dig into some more music with you. I love sharing music, as many of you know. And this week I'm going to do two things. One thing is do a composer profile, kind of a spotlight on a composer that I'm really excited about. And then we're going to dig into more of some of that world music crossover stuff that I love. So the reason I wanted to do this composer spotlight is because I wanted to turn everyone on to something really cool that Spotify does. And if you don't currently have a Spotify account, you can definitely take a look and get one of the free accounts. But they do something that is called a Composer Weekly. And basically, it's a weekly playlist that a composer, a living composer, they've done some on some of the classical composers, like Mozart, for example, but normally it's living composers who curate a playlist of their music. And I think that's really cool because basically the composer puts together pieces that they want to introduce and that they want to talk about and that they want to be in this playlist. And it happens every single week. So again, it's the Spotify list that's called Composer Weekly. And you can subscribe to that playlist or just check out whatever's on there, and it comes out each week. And one of the things that they do is they have the composer themselves do a little verbal introduction. And so I have that ready to play for you for the composer I've chosen to spotlight. So the composer that we're going to talk about today, I'm going to play probably five or six pieces from him, is a composer called David Lang. David Lang is a Pulitzer Prize-winning composer. He is a modern classical music composer, but he does a lot of interesting music. I would say that he's known for really innovative piano music, really interesting vocal music, and also some great things with strings, some orchestra stuff as well. But the things that I like of his compositions are his piano music and his vocal music, which we're going to listen to some of. But to get started, let's hear David Lang speak in his own words about this composer's playlist. So here's David Lang talking about his
really
music.
Happy to be the featured composer on this Composer's Weekly playlist. I chose everything on this playlist myself. I did this just for you. I tried to give you a range of things that I've been doing. So I've been writing music for over 50 years now, which is hard to believe, but most of the stuff here is pretty recent because I wanted to let you know what I've been up to. In the last few years, I've been writing a huge amount of vocal music, so there's a bunch of that represented here. There's some songs, there's some choral things. There's a little bit from The Little Match Girl Passion, which is the piece that I wrote that won the Pulitzer Prize. There's also some films that I've done here. So there's music from the films Youth, The Great Beauty, The Woodmans. I really hope you like those. And there's also a range of just the other kinds of things that, you know, classical composers do. There's orchestra music and chamber music. And there's even a new track here, a piece called Forced March, that I did for the Crash Ensemble in Dublin, and we recorded it in U2's old studio, which was fantastic. And that's going to be coming out on a CD on Cantaloupe in the spring. I really hope you enjoy this playlist, and have fun.
All right. So that's David Lang, the composer that we're going to be listening to today. And as you heard, he has a wide variety of things. And it's absolutely amazing that he has been playing music and writing music for, as he said, over 50 years. I kind of can't even believe it, because I think his music sounds really fresh and really new. And of course, he's writing right now as well. He's just got a great ear for the modern sound and a great sense of that, and I just think it's really interesting music. So again, if you're interested, those are the Spotify Composer Weekly segments. It's a Composer Weekly playlist curated by the composers. Okay, so let's dig into David Lang's music. The first piece, we're not going to play everything from the playlist, but the first piece I'm going to play for you, as I said, we're going to play about five or six pieces, is a piano piece, and the piece is the third movement from a group of pieces called Memory Pieces. And this third movement is called Wed. It's about 5 minutes. It's very meditative, a little bit melancholy. Perhaps some people will describe it as spiritual. I first heard about these pieces because a friend of mine who is a pianist, Danny Holt, Danny, if you're listening, hey, who has come out to Utah and done some concerts out here, and we're actually planning some concerts in Palm Springs together later this year. But he has recorded a little bit of this David Lang, these memory pieces, and there's several of them, and I'd like to read you a little bit of the program notes so you know. Again, they're called Memory Pieces. And the individual movements are Cage, Spartan Arcs, Wed, the one you're going to hear, Grind, Diet Coke, Cello, Wiggle, and Beach. So really interesting titles. This is what David Lang, the composer, writes about the pieces. And he says, one of the horrifying things about growing older is that your friends don't all grow older with you. People grow sick and they die. You watch, you try to comfort them. How long can you hold on to the sound of a voice, a memory of a strange event, a bittersweet feeling, or a silly story? He says that I was friends with all the dedicatees of the enclosed set of pieces. Some were closer friends than others, and I have a very personal memories of my dealings with them that I don't want to fade. Each of these little pieces highlights some aspect of my relationship with each friend. I hope this will help me hold on to these memories just a little while longer. So this is Wed, the third movement from David Lang's Memory Pieces. Thank you. All right. So that was Memory Pieces, the third movement from Memory Pieces, which is called Wed. The composer is David Lang. This is Lynn Vartan, and this is the Apex Hour at KSUU Thunder 91.1. The next song by David Lang that I'd like to play for you is a song called This Was Written by Hand. It's longer, so I'm not going to actually play the whole thing because I want to make sure to get you a sampling of a lot of his music. This Is Written by Hand is another piano piece. It's a little bit different. And this is what David Lang has to say about that piece. He says, I was taught to write music with a pencil. I remember those days so well. I would sit patiently at my desk, singing the music to myself and then writing it down. If I was tense about a project or a deadline, I would hold the pencil so tight that I would get blisters on my fingers and my arm would cramp up and take weeks to recover. Writing music was an intensely physical activity. I got my first computer in 1993, and I have not written music with a pencil ever since. But I often wonder how or if the means of my writing had any effect on the writing itself. I wrote this piano piece to find out. So it's kind of an interesting concept. He's seeing if he can remember what writing by hand is like. So this is the piano piece called This Was Written by Hand by David Lang. So that was This Is Written by Hand by David Lang. And again, it's part of a longer work. So if you're interested in listening to more of it, you definitely can check it out. David Lang, the composer that we're listening to for the first half of this show, that piece he was describing or experiencing what it felt like to write by hand as he learned writing by pencil and then transferred to the computer later. But you can hear in his music, especially in his piano music, that sense of openness. And there's a little bit of melancholy. I imagine that his music can be amazing with dance, for example. So any aspiring choreographers out there, definitely take a listen to some of the music, especially the piano music of David Lang. It's really great stuff. I just find it to be meditative and spacious, but yet has a lot of great modern harmonies in it. Okay, so now I'd like to move on to some vocal music of David. I've got a few more that I'd like to play for you. This song is called Just, and it's from the film Youth. He mentioned, as you heard earlier in the broadcast, that he has all kinds of things in this playlist. And again, this is the Spotify playlist called Composer Weekly, featuring David Lang. And this song, Just, again, is also a longer work. We're going to not listen to all of it. We'll take a listen to some of it. And one of the things that's interesting about his vocal music is that there's a similarity to the piano music. You'll hear the same kind of linear or melodic line that kind of layers over and over. And he also has a program note for this piece. And one other thing to listen for in his music is he has a great sense of Baltic choral qualities, Eastern European sort of vocal sounds in it. But this is the program note for this piece, and it tells you a little more about what it's about. Just is a setting of text I made by finding certain things in the Song of Songs. The original text is, of course, the most passionate and erotic of the ancient Jewish books, and it is always strange to encounter it in the Bible. In 2008, I wrote a choral piece called For Love is Strong, in which I made a similar text from the Song of Songs, trying to use the words to see through the relationship between the man and the woman in the story to the relationship between man and God. According to Jewish tradition, the Song of Songs is a metaphor for our passion for the eternal, so the words themselves become very important. He goes on to say that for his text, he listed everything personal or owned that is attributed to the man and to the woman. To clarify who is speaking, he starts each phrase of his with just your, and each phrase of hers with and my. It is interesting that in a text about love that is shared, there are only seven instances of our. So it's a really interesting take on the Song of Solomon, but this song is called Just. The composer is David Lang.
Just your eyes, just your mane, just your hair, just your teeth, just your lips, just your mouth, just your cheeks, just your veil, just your neck, just your two breasts, and my love, and my bride, and my heart, and my sister, and my bride, and my heart, just your eyes, just your necklace, just your love, and my sister, and my bride, just your love, just your oils, just your lips, and my bride, just your tongue, just your garments, and my sister, and my bride. Just your sheets and my garden and my beloved and my garden and my sister and my bride and my myrrh and my spice and my honeycomb and my honey and my wine and my milk and my heart and my beloved and my sister and my love and my dove and my perfect one and my head and my locks and my garment and my feet and my beloved and my hand and my heart and my beloved.
Okay, so that song that you're hearing, again, it goes on. That song is called Just, and it's after the Song of Songs, and the movie it goes with is called Youth. The composer is David Lang, and you're listening to the Apex Hour. This is Lynn Vartan, and this is KSUU Thunder 91.1. We're doing a little composer spotlight of David Lang, and then I have two more of his to play, and then we're going to get into some wacky world music. And the two remaining David Lang songs both have that crossover element that I'm interested in. The first one is less obvious. This piece is called, it's from a series of pieces called Death Speaks. And this is the first one that's called You Will Return. Again, the composer is David Lang. And one of the things that's really interesting about this is he decided to look at, in classical music, all the instances where death was attributed to a person or an entity or a personality. So he went through, like, for example, Schubert's songs, Death and the Maiden, and he went through the remaining Schubert pieces and found all the places where death was personified. And what he did was he took excerpts from 32 songs, translating them, trimming them, and it's similar to something that he did with Little Match Girl Passion, the piece that won him the Pulitzer Prize. And these death songs actually were originally meant to be on the same album with the Match Girl Passion, Little Match Girl Passion. And so that's kind of the basis of the story. But what makes it crossover? Because you're probably thinking, well, that doesn't sound very crossover. But then he asked a bunch of rock musicians to join him. So Bryce Nessner, Owen Pallett, Sharon Warden, and then another composer, Nico Muhly, who I've mentioned on this show before, who certainly is involved with classical music, but is really open to incorporating elements of rock. So he incorporated them into these different pieces. So he started thinking about indie rock and how it bumps up against classical music and this idea of how these concepts of personifying death could fit very well in rock music, also fit very well in classical music. So he said, what would it be like to put together an ensemble of successful indie composer performers and invite them back into classical music, the world from which they sprang? So that's how he got these other people involved. So this is the one that has Cher Worden and involved with the piece. And again, it's Death Speaks, number one, You Will Return by David Lang.
You will return to dust.
David Lang with Shara Warden, and yes, that piece is called You Will Return, and it's the first movement from Death Speaks. This is KSUU Thunder 91.1. My name is Lynn Bartan, and this is the Apex Hour. We're doing a composer spotlight, and I have one more little snippet, and this is the last of the David Lang pieces, and it's also a crossover. And the reason I want to play this one for you is because this piece is, it's not a piece you can buy, like, you can't buy the performance materials, you can't. If you, it's for voice and cello, and if you've got a cellist and you're a singer and you want to do this piece, you can't. This arrangement is not available. It's unusual for classical music to not be able to perform a piece, and so I want to give a little bit of a snippet of it because it's kind of a special piece. The title is Heroin, and it's originally the Lou Reed piece. So we're talking Velvet Underground, and then David Lang arranged it for voice and cello. So again, it's kind of this classical crossover into early rock and roll or alternative music. And this is what David says. He says, Heroin was commissioned by the Brooklyn Academy of Music's Next Wave Festival in 2002. At that time, I was trying to think of moments in my life when I learned a lesson that turned out later to be important to me. I remembered that I had been a very nerdy classical music person who in high school got very interested in rock and roll. I thought I knew the kind of emotional narrative of each world. Classical music was for big, noble thoughts and ideas. Rock and roll was for dancing and girls. Then I heard the Velvet Underground. Actually, the first Velvet Underground song I heard was the dark and very disturbing Venus in Furs with its droning viola and the crazy lyrics. I remember thinking that this music was dangerous, and I'd never thought of any other music that way. This association of music and danger is something I've tried to capture many times in the years since. For this song, I wanted to see if I could recall that feeling of danger by setting Lou Reed's lyrics with my new music. Heroin was the first song off that record that I transformed this way. So just a little bit of it. Again, it's a longer version of this song, but just to give you a little taste, this is Heroin, David Lang for voice and cello. In the background there is the song Heroin, originally by Lou Reed and the Velvet Underground, done and arranged for voice and cello by David Lang, our composer spotlight here on the Apex Hour on KSUU Thunder 91.1. That's the end of our composer spotlight. Now I have some fun world music crossover stuff for you. We're just going to get right into it. I found out about this guy, and I believe you pronounce his name Qais Essar, and he is an instrumentalist who plays the Afghan rabab, which is a very, very old instrument, very old string instrument. But and I'd heard he was classically trained, and then turned this into kind of avant-garde pop, if you will. So it's a really sort of remaking of this instrument. The song is called The Ghosts You Love the Most. And he has this quote that describes the song for him. He says, "I imagine waking up on the other side feels very much like the sensation you feel when you place your face on the cool side of a pillow." So he captures this feeling of simple pleasure perfectly, transforms it into this sort of lighter, interesting pop song. He has 4 albums that have all been very, very popular, and he's gotten a bunch of different nominations for his use of this music in film. But let's have a listen to The Ghost You Love the Most on Rabab by Qais Essar.
Thank you.
The Ghost You Love Most by Kaisa Sarr. And that instrument is a rabab. And it's an Afghan instrument. And I think he does a really cool job of like bringing that kind of into sort of modern pop music. Moving on, this next song I have for you is called Africa La by Beto Vilares. And Beto is a Brazilian producer, a composer. He's done a ton. In fact, I know him because he was one of the producers on the album by Seiyu, who I really like, and really got more into his music. He's got a lot of different things involved in it. This is the song called Africa La, and it's got influences from everywhere. Brazil, it's got some movie kind of sounds. It's got a little bit of jazz and Bill Evans. It's got a little bit of hip hop in it. He's just got a lot of different kinds of sounds that are in this. And have a listen. KSU Thunder 91.1, this is Africa La by Beto Vilares.
Olha só que lindo rebolado, só dei uma olhada e já não paro de pensar. Queria ser o dono do babado, chefe da brincadeira, vou mandar tudo parar. Só fica eu e a nega no tablado, pandeiro batucando uma cuica pra chorar.
Fui hipnotizado, a nega vai e vem, dançando bem colado, com ela vou também. Fui hipnotizado, a nega vai e vem, dançando bem colado, com ela vou também.
Quando eu vi aquele rebolado, uma tontura esquisita começou a me dominar. É que eu não estou habituado, só sei que essa neguinha tomou conta do lugar. Ela tem um ar dissimulado, tem um jeito diferente, não para de dançar. Fica todo mundo alucinado, ela cheia de malícia, finge nada reparar.
Fui hipnotizado, a nega vai e vem, dançando bem colado, com ela vou também. Fui hipnotizado, a nega vai e vem, dançando bem colado, com ela vou também.
África lá no Brasil, todo mundo aí, quase perdi uma mão quando te encontrei. África lá no Brasil, todo mundo aí, quase perdi o meu rumo quando te encontrei.
Tem que ter muito gingado pra poder se aproximar. Além de ser a deusa do bailado, o desinteressado e a todos evitar, leva sempre junto agarrado sua mãe, sua tia, seu irmão pra vigiar.
Fui hipnotizada, nega, vai e vem dançando bem, colado com ela, vou também. Fui hipnotizada, nega, vai e vem dançando bem, colado com ela, vou também.
Fui hipnotizada,
nega, vai e vem dançando bem, colado com ela, vou também.
Fui hipnotizada,
nega, vai e vem dançando bem, colado com ela, vou. Treme terra no Pará. O malucão deixando o norte bem doidão. Em Cuiabá o Siriri faz balançar. O alemão, a japonesa e o negão. O Maranhão dança reggae de montão. Lá em Manaus todo mundo dança house. O swing do baião, do cavaçal, os caras em bom maneiro, paus. África lá no Brasil, todo mundo aí, quase perdi o meu rumo quando te encontrei. África lá no Brasil, todo mundo aí, quase perdi o meu rumo quando te encontrei. África lá no Brasil, todo mundo aí, quase perdi o meu rumo quando te encontrei. África lá no Brasil, todo mundo aí, quase perdi o meu rumo quando te encontrei.
Como sou alguém determinado, vou mostrar meu swing e conseguir impressionar. Posso até ficar bem comportado, sou rei dessa folia, já brinquei até cansar. Deixa agora até com o cunhado, com a mãe, com a tia, com quem mais precisar. Eu vou me tornar sua namorada, no final da brincadeira estarei pronto pra casar.
Fui hipnotizado, a nega vai e vem, dançando bem colado, com ela vou também. Fui hipnotizado, a nega vai e vem, dançando bem colado, com ela vou também. Fui hipnotizado.
hipnotizada, nem cabai. Dançando bem colado, com ela vou também. Fui hipnotizada, nem cabai. Dançando bem colado, com ela vou também.
Right. Well, that song was Africa Law, and the artist is Beto Vilares, a great producer, songwriter, and Brazilian musician. You're listening to the Apex Hour. This is Lynn Vartan, KSU Thunder 91.1. Moving on, this group that I'm going to play for you now, I just love. They're called Rupa and the April Fishes. And the song we're going to do here is C'est Moi, and they're considered a global alternative group. Again, the second half of the show is all world music with some kind of crossover type influence. They're based in San Francisco, and the group says that their songs are a mixture of styles ranging from jazz to punk to reggae to chanson, French song style, with lyrics in multiple languages, French, Spanish, and English. They began as a duo. They've come together as a group. They started in clubs, and they really have a lot of different styles and influence. Their music is really multifaceted, constantly sort of redefining genres. One funny thing is that their name derives from an old French saying that's kind of like April Fool's. I guess it's an April Fool's tradition in France for people to stick paper fishes on the back of the unsuspecting. While the origin of the custom is questionable, Rupa remarks, one of the stories is that when a French king changed to the Roman calendar from the pagan calendar that had been used at the time, some people still wanted to celebrate the new year in April. So these are the people who would give the fishes the April fish to celebrate the beginning of the new year. Now, for the group, that is they've sort of turned it a little bit more into a political commentary, and you can read more about that if you're interested. But that's kind of the origin of their name, which I didn't know until I was researching for today's show. So Rupa and the April Fishes. This song is called C'est Moi.
C'est moi qui ai dit pourquoi pas. Maintenant c'est moi qui dis pourquoi. C'est moi qui étais la courageuse. Maintenant c'est moi ici la peureuse. Yeah. main dès que deux et deux font quatre. Je n'ai jamais vu aucune chose qui respire, qui fait comme ça. Je n'en sais rien de l'amour, je ne sais rien, mon amour. Je suis amoureuse de toi.
That was Rupa and the April Fishes. The song is called C'est Moi, and it's just kind of a party. I don't know. I just think it's very like Cirque du Soleil, or it just has this kind of magical, playful quality. So let's keep the party going. I have one song left, and this is just fun. It's jazz. It's fun. The artist is Nina Freeland, world-renowned jazz singer, composer, producer, arranger, Grammy nominee, the whole deal. But the song is called Better Than Anything, and here we are on the longest day of the year, and what could be better than anything? All the great things about summer. So KSUU Thunder 91.1, Better Than Anything.
Better than sailing at midnight, better than diving for pearls, better than skiing at Aspen, better than feeding the squirrels, better than finding a horseshoe, better than losing your head, better than anything borrowed, better than anything said, better than singing right out loud or being spotted in a crowd, better than anything except being in love. Checking in at Monterey, better than anything except being in love. Better than Lucy and Desi, better than Route 66, better than Huntley and Brinkley, better than quiz shows all fixed, better than guesting. Backstage with a pass or getting paid in full in cash. Better than anything except being in love, love, love. We'll be right back. Elephants dancing, clowns on parade, peanut popcorn and fresh lemonade, rides on the midway seals blowing horns, being shot from cannons of fresh is gone. Tigers lead through fire. Better than anything. Oh, yeah. Except being in love. Yes, it's
that party that you're hearing is Better Than Anything by Nina Freeland here on the Apex Hour. And that is all the time we have today. Thanks so much for listening. If you think of it, please leave us a review for the podcast, either on iTunes or Google Play or wherever you get your podcasts. We would love to get the news out there of all the stuff we're doing here on the Apex Hour. And again, enjoy this longest day of the year, and we'll see you next week.
Thanks so much for listening to the Apex Hour here on KSUU Thunder 91.1. Come find us again next Thursday at 3 p.m. for more conversations with the visiting guests at Southern Utah University and new music to discover for your next playlist. And in the meantime, we would love to see you at our events on campus. To find out more, check out suu.edu/apex. Until next week, this is Lynn Vartan saying goodbye from the Apex Hour here on Thunder 91.1.